Hey Stevie, I have a customer asking how do you configure and use autofill keyword sets in OnBase? Could you help me out?
Sure, Austin, I'd be happy to help you with that. Let me share my screen.
Autofill keyword sets are awesome because they increase the speed and accuracy of indexing. In order to configure an autofill keyword set, we'll start in config. In config, select keyword, autofill keyword set. In the text field towards the bottom, we're going to name our autofill keyword set. In this case, we're going to name it AF Employee Information, and then select Create. Now, this is the part where your database admin comes into play, as typically they have the flat file that you need. You want to go ahead and open your flat file and use this information to set the keywords that will be a part of your autofill keyword set. And this will represent the structure in the database, and it's very important that the keyword types are in the same sequence as this text file for this to work properly. So I'll go ahead and add in my keyword types. Always double check your work for accuracy before hitting save, because once this autofill keyword set is created, it cannot be deleted and the keyword types within it cannot be modified. And OnBase will remind you of that as well. The user groups that you assign to your autofill keyword set will be based upon your business need, but in this instance, I'll just assign a manager group. The next step in configuration of an autofill keyword set will go to import and autofill keyword processor. Your name might be different, but here, we'll name this AF Employee Info Processor and hit create. You want to browse out to that same flat file that we used earlier. Choose an autofill keyword set to fill. Of course, we'll use the one we created. Now, if we're looking at the flat file, you want to map out the delimiter and the separator. Just as a side note, a delimiter holds values within a text file, and the separator splits those values apart from each other. In this instance, the delimiter is going to be a double quote, and the separator is a comma. Fill that in. So now we're going to assign a document type to our autofill keyword set. We can pretty much close that out. We'll go to document, document types. We're gonna select the document type that the autofill keyword set was configured for. In this case, it was the AFW4 form, and we'll select keyword types. In the bottom left from the dropdown autofill keyword set, we're going to set that to the autofill keyword set that we just created. And then select save. Can close all of this out, and we'll reset the cache of the application service just to make sure that our changes take effect. Now, one important step is, of course, we want to open up the OnBase client and import our autofill keyword set. This is just to make sure that it's being recognized within OnBase. This is an important step. You just want to make sure that you don't forget it. You can schedule this to run, but for now, we're just going to execute it. Awesome. That was successful. So we're going to go ahead and close this out. Just as a reminder, you can use autofill keyword sets within whatever client that you typically use. However, because the Unity client is my best friend, we'll go ahead and open this up in the Unity client. Now for the fun part, let's actually put this all into practice. We're going to select import, browse out to the file that's related to the document type, which is AFW4 form. Now here, for the employee ID, this is the primary keyword, so we're going to go ahead and fill this out. 121, if configured correctly, when you hit tab, it'll fill out all of the other information for you. Then you can go ahead and import. And there you have it. That's how you configure an autofill keyword set.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. If you have a question that you would like answered on an upcoming question corner, please leave a comment below.